In Excel, we can create QR codes in bulk for free for use in any application using a formula. And unlike Google Sheets, you can simply copy the image and paste it where you need it. QR codes can be used to open URLs, store mobile tickets, contactless payments, even obituaries on headstones, to name a few. And because they're simply a graphical representation of alphanumeric strings, they don't expire. Now, there are a couple of ways you can create QR codes in Excel. We'll start with the image function technique, which is available with Microsoft 365. And then I'll show you an alternate way, which allows you to create colored QR codes and works in all versions of Excel. And at the end, I'm going to answer some frequently asked questions, so stay tuned. The trick with the image function is to use Google's QR code generator API, which you can find on their developer's site. Now, to save you having to remember where to find this API and how to write the formula, I've created an Excel file you can download from the link in the video description with the formulas ready to go. But let me step through how it works so you know how to modify it for your needs. To demonstrate, I'll create QR codes for this list of courses. But first, let's take a closer look at Google's QR code API. It's made up of the root URL and then three required parameters which specify that it's a QR code, the width and height you want the QR code, and the alphanumeric string, binary bytes of data, or kanji. There's also a list of optional parameters which I'll let you explore in your own time. But back in Excel, I'll use the image function to fetch the QR code. And then in double quotes, I'll paste in the Google API URL plus the three required parameters which I've already copied to my clipboard, and then close the double quotes. Notice I've set the size to 150 by 150, and you can change it here, but it's easy to introduce a typo. So I'll show you another way we can have the size as an input parameter that's unbreakable later in the video. Next, I need to concatenate the URL on the end using the ampersand and the cell reference, C3. Now I could leave it there, but with the image function, we can also return some alt text, which I'll make the URL. Next, I can choose the sizing. I recommend 2 so that it retains its original size. And lastly, the image function also allows you to resize images, but I don't recommend it because you could end up with a blurry QR code. So I'll press enter, and because this list is in a table, it automatically copies the formula down, and voila. Now you may need to resize the cells to display the QR code properly. If you create QR codes regularly, or you want to hand this task off to someone less experienced with Excel, then you can create a custom lambda function. And that way you don't need to remember the Google API URL, and less experienced users won't accidentally break the formulas. It might sound scary, but it's pretty straightforward, and you'll find the finished function in the file you can download from the video description. But first, let me show you how it's constructed in case you want to make some modifications. I'll use the advanced formula environment to write the lambda because it has more space. It's a free add-in. Now, if you don't already have it, go to the Home tab, Add-ins, plus more add-ins, and search for Excel Labs, and then add it. Then you'll find it on the Home tab, open Excel Labs, and go to the Advanced Formula Environment. Here on the Names tab, click the plus icon to create a new function. So my function name will be FN Get QR Code. Now it's a good idea to differentiate custom functions from built-in functions by prefixing them with FN or the lambda symbol. I've also used some lowercase letters, which you never see in built-in functions. Shout out to Peter Bartholomew for this tip. Next, the description pops up as a tooltip when you use the function, so I'll put the syntax in here. FN Get QR Code. Now my formula will be used to create QR codes for URLs. So the first argument will be URL for QR. And I'm going to allow my users to specify the size that they want. So the next argument will be the size of the QR. Then I just list the arguments URL and size. I'll make the pane wider so we have more room. And now I can define the function, which is based on the image function that I used earlier. So I'm just going to paste it in and then replace the hard-keyed parameters with my variable names. So we need to terminate the start of the URL with a double quote and then concatenate the variable name, then another ampersand and a double quote around the X, and repeat that for the next size parameter. Then I'll replace both references to the course URL with the URL variable and click done. Okay, let's test it out. I can use it just like a regular function. The first argument is the URL I want the QR code for, and then the size, and I'm done. I think you'll agree this will be much easier for Excel beginners. If you want to copy the Lambda to other files, simply copy the sheet that the Lambda is in to a new file, and then you can delete the sheet and it will still be in the name manager for use in that new file. If you like the way we can simplify tasks in Excel with formulas like this and you want to master more, check out my advanced Excel formulas course. You'll find the link in the video description. Now, the nice thing about the formula-based QR codes is they will update if you change the text in the cell they reference. Another way we can create QR codes in Excel is with a free add-in, which is available in all currently supported Excel versions. Plus, we can create colored QR codes, which you can't do with the image function technique. To get the add-in, go to the Home tab, Add-ins, Get Add-ins, search for QR for Office, and press Add. Then access the add-in from the Home tab, Add-ins, My Add-ins, and select it. The add-in opens a task pane on the right. I'm just going to drag it over closer to the list of URLs. And all we need to do now is select the cell containing the text or URL that you want converted to a QR code, and then click the copy icon. It detects the type of text you're encoding, but you can change it from the dropdown. Then select the color you want. You can also select background color. Drag the slider to alter the size. I won't make it too big. And you can change the error correction settings. Before inserting it, check the preview. And when you're happy, insert it. Now this results in an image object that you can move around or cut and paste into other apps. The downside of this method is you have to generate them one by one, and if you have changes to the URL or alphanumeric string, then you have to recreate them manually. Now, if it's color QR codes you want, you can copy and paste ones created using the image function as a picture. First, remove any cell formats because these will also be copied. I'll make the table formatting plain, and then copy the cell containing the QR code and paste it as a linked picture. This way, if the original QR code changes, it will reflect those changes. Then on the picture format tab under color, choose a new color from the rig color gallery, or choose one from the palette. And now I have a QR code image that I can copy and paste to other apps. The maximum size you can make the ones with the QR code add-in appears to be 375, although I have had different results depending on the URL that I'm encoding. And with the image function, it's 547. However, you can zoom in on the page to make it bigger without much loss of resolution, which is good. You may notice that Google have deprecated their static charts, which the QR code is one of, way back in 2012. Given that it's over a decade later, it doesn't appear that they're planning on removing the API, but even if they do, any QR codes you've created with it will still work. Of the three options, I think the Lambda function is the best. If you'd like to master the Lambda function to streamline more of your work, check out this video next. And if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.